Hello everybody and welcome back to this tutorial. And what we did in the previous one is we actually coded a simple, or we didn't code, we just checked out what the if statement can do for us. Right now what we are going to do is we are going to check out what the if else statement does, and we are going to code a simple password checker for us. Now first of all, before we start coding, let us check out the if else statement. So go up, open up your IDLE or your Python 3 or however you want to call it, and let's actually check out what we can do with the if-else statement. So first of all, we're going to do the same thing as in the previous video. So we will set some variable to be equal to 5, and we will set some variable b to be equal to 5 as well. And then we're going to perform the if-else statement. So if a equals equals to b, we're going to print simply just, let me just find the single quotes. Okay, here they are. These two values are the same. So simple as that. So these two values are the same. What we want to do right now is just go right here. Let me just go right here. So else. Oops. Unintended does not match any outer indentation level. Let me just see, because I'm not really sure if I am supposed to tab it or not. So we'll just type it once again. If a equals b, print, and we will just print the same thing. These two values are the same. And we will then type here else. Unintended does not match any outer indentation level. What do you mean? Why won't you work like this? Or, okay, we'll just do it like this. It is rather easier, so just go to the new file right here. Or maybe we are not even supposed to tab the actual print statement, so let me just check it another time. Third luck. So print, these two values are the same. And then else. Okay, never mind. It says invalid syntax. We'll just go right here and we will do the same thing. So what we are going to do is set the a to be equal to 5, b to be equal to 5, and we are going to perform the if-else statement. So if a equals equals to b, we'll print right here the same thing as we did in the previous three tries. So these two values are the same. In any other case, we will use an else statement, and there we will print these two values are not the same. So simple as that. So these two values are not the same! Exclamation mark. And what this basically will do is it will check, basically it will do as it says, it will check whether a equals to b. If it is equal to b, it will print this statement right here. If it is not equal to b, or if you, should I say else, it will print these two values are not the same. So let us try to run this module right here. So run module. Okay, so it must be saved. So let us go to the desktop, second program.py. Run it, these two values are the same. So you can see it finishes relatively fast. It prints out these two values are the same. So everything works perfectly. Right now, let me just find the program itself. Right now, let us switch it up a little bit. We will set the b to be equal to 3. And right now, if we perform this program or run this program once again, it shouldn't print this, it should actually print this. So let us go right here. Run the actual program, run module, it must be saved, we saved it, and you can see the different string gets printed out to the screen. So these two values are not the same. So that is the simple use of the actual if-else statement. Now you can do different things with it, such as, for example, let's check it right like this. If a is greater than b, let me just do it like this. We will not print this. What we will do is we will print, we will actually add b to b, we will add 2 to b, so b equals b plus 2. And then at the end, or right here, let me just first of all switch this as well, right here, if the a is really bigger than b, or if a is not bigger than b, we will make a to be equal to a plus 2 as well. And at the end, we are going to print these two values, print a and also print b. So what this will do, since a is 5 and b is 3, it will not execute this statement right here. It will only execute this statement right here. And these two print statements should actually print both 5. So it, both a and both b will be equal to 5. Now make sure that if you actually copy this right here, so copy these two statements, whoops, where did they go? Okay, so copy these two statements and put them before the if-else loop right here, you will see that we will get two different results. First of all, this will print out these two values, and then it will perform the if-else loop or statement, and then it will perform the different values. So let us run it. If I just click here on run, run module, save it, you can see we get printed out 5355. Since the first two values were a equals 5, b equals 3, and the second two values after the if-else statement was b equals 5 and a equals 5. So that is our simple if-else statement. Right now, let us code an actual useful program for the first time, which will be a simple password checker. So we're going to do it like this. We can use the same program right here. We're just going to delete all of this. And let us first of all think about it. So what do we need to implement for our password checker? Well, of course, there first of all needs to be a password. So let us just type here password. We will use a simple variable password to be equal to, for example, 1, 2, or let us just do something like this. Capital P or password 1, 1, 2, 3, which is the usual password that everybody uses. So this is the actual password. And let us think what we need to do in order for this to work. So first of all, the user of this program will need to input some password. Therefore, we already know that we're going to use that input function that will pause the program and wait for the user to type something in. Then what we need to do afterwards is actually just compare the inputted password with the password that the actual program has stored in this password variable right here. Basically, if they do match, which will be in the if statement, if they do match, we'll print access granted. If they don't match, we'll print access denied. Please enter the password again. Or please run the program again. So let us see how we can do that. We will make a variable called user or inputted password. So inputted underscore password. So we know what this variable is and we don't confuse it with the password variable right here. We'll make it to be equal to the actual input. So input right here. We are using the input function. Between that, we need to specify the single quotes. And between the single quotes, we're going to specify to user what they need to do. So please enter the password. We'll specify two dots and a space. And this will basically just prompt the user with this statement right here. Then once we actually input the password, let us just convert it real quick to the actual string. Even though this is not something that you should do, but you can do it if you want to. Sometimes it might present problems, so it is always good to do something like this so your program doesn't crash. So what we did basically is we created our inputted password to be equal to the string value. So if, for example, user types in an integer right here, we don't really want an integer to be compared to a string because it will give us an error. We want to compare a string to a string. So all we are left to do right now is perform the if-else statement. So if inputted password underscore password is equal to the password that the program has specified at the beginning, which is this one right here, we want to print can print something like this. Correct password. And we can print. Oops, where is the quote? Okay, so here it is. Access granted. And then in the else statement, so if user specifies basically anything that is not a correct password, we want to print simply wrong password, 3 exclamation marks, and also print access denied. So the user knows that they didn't get the password right. So access denied. And 3 exclamation marks. So simple as that. Let us save this program. So save it to the secondprogram.py. And all we want to do is try to run it in our actual shell. So run, run module. Right here we can see we get the actual string prompted to please enter the password. And let's type here hello world. You can see we get wrong password, access denied. So hello world is not an actual password. Let us try to actually specify a wrong password once again. So run module once again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Wrong password, access denied. Let us now try to specify the right password, which is the capital P, and then password 1, 2, 3. Let us run the program. Password 1, 2, 3. And you can see correct password, access granted. So our actual password checker works correctly. This is first useful program that we actually coded. It is rather short one, as we can see. It is only few lines of code. And there it is really easy to understand. Nothing really too complicated here yet. And basically that would be about it for this tutorial. What we are going to do in the next one is we are going to take a look at the if-else statement with multiple else-if statements. Now, what I mean by that is sometimes, for example, you want to check three different outcomes. For example, if inputted password equals to password. Also, if inputted password equals to password in capital letters, else, and then some different things. So, for example, that. Or if number, you will see the example that we are going to do will be if number is greater than zero, print number is greater than zero. If number is equal to zero, print number is equal to zero. And also if number is smaller than zero, print number is smaller than zero. That is what we are going to do in the next video. So hope you enjoyed this tutorial and I hope I see you in the next lecture. Bye.